Good afternoon, guys. So we have started income tax discussion in a basic chapter. Today we have target to finish basic chapter. All right, let's see if we can. Otherwise tomorrow we'll finishing it. But almost basic concepts are done, okay, except 2 or 3. This is independent chapter that I am merging into basic concept, okay, scope of total income. Importance of this chapter is that today you are going to learn what types of incomes are taxable in India, in what type of assessee's hand. Okay, so there are 3 types of income and there are 3 types of assessees. Okay, 3 types of income and 3 types of assessees. Very basically I can tell you there are two major types of assessees, which are resident and non-resident. Okay, so assessee can be, come on, tell me, assessee can be resident or non-resident. Without going into anything detail, you tell me who should be paying taxes in India, resident or non-resident?
Resident.
Obviously resident should pay tax. Why the hell non-resident should pay tax in India? Yes or no? Non-resident is someone residing in China. Obviously you cannot go in China and collect, Indian government is asking for some tax. Alright, that will be completely weird situation. But if China guy or Chinese guy is coming to India and he is earning money in India, then hello, then he should pay tax because he is earning in India. Okay, so far as non-resident is concerned, we take money from that non-resident who is having Indian income. Hello, easy? So far as non-resident is concerned, we only take tax on Indian income. Okay, we don't take tax on foreign income. A best example I can give of cricketers, because many of people are following cricketers. Alright, so Chris Gayle or Brett Lee or Ricky Ponting or any other foreign cricket player that you like, he comes to India, he plays in our IPL, yes or no?
Yes.
Alright, and then they are earning 5 crore, 10 crore rupees. Should they pay tax in India on that income?
Yes.
Yes or no?
Yes.
Right, apart from playing in cricket, they also advertise. Okay, they work in some advertisement, they become brand ambassadors and, you know, campaign advertiser of a particular company, then on that income,
yeah,
they should pay tax because they are earning this money in
India.
Alright. But if Chris Gayle from India, he finished IPL matches, now he traveled to Sri Lanka and he is playing match in Sri Lanka, should he pay tax on that income?
No.
No. At least not in India. Okay. About Sri Lanka will look after.
Yes.
But at least he should not pay tax in India.
India.
And so far as the resident is concerned, okay, please understand, ordinarily, okay, ordinarily, there are 2 types of resident, ordinary resident and non-ordinary resident. We call it OR and NOR. Ordinary resident pays tax on global income. Ordinary resident pay tax on
global income
because government is quite possessive about him. You have to pay tax on global income because you are an ordinary resident. If you don't pay, then who will pay?
Yes.
Hello?
Yes.
You, everyone sitting here, I hope you people stay only in India.
Yes.
Or do you travel like 2-3 months outside India, then in India? Is it like that, or you stay in India?
Yes.
You stay in India, isn't it your obligation to pay tax in India?
Yes.
Yes, yes or no?
Yes.
Alright. So sir, we will pay tax in India. That's good. Sir, but which income? So there are 2 types of income. Indian income. Hello? And
foreign
income. So listen, ordinary resident pay tax on Indian income as well as on foreign income. You tell me why he is paying tax on foreign income. Because you are Indian. Hello?
Yes.
He has to pay tax on Indian income because you are Indian. We need taxes. We need development. You need development. We means you need development. You need better roads. You need better infra. Then it is your obligation to pay taxes. Not only on Indian income but also on foreign income. But if you talk about non-resident, non-resident has to pay tax only on Indian income. He is not responsible to pay tax on foreign income. Am I clear? I am not talking anything about this guy, that we will discuss later, because that then law will go in some different way. Let us discuss thumb rules first. Thumb rule, okay? The first thumb rule is that all the, so far as if your residential status is ordinary resident, you should not be asking me what type of incomes are taxable, Indian or foreign, because whether you earn in India or whether you earn outside India, it is taxable in India because you are ordinary resident. If you are non-resident, then that question makes sense, because for non-resident we are not taking tax on whole world's income. Okay, that is not taxable in India. Only one simple part on this world, that is India. If you earn here, then only you have to pay tax. Are we clear about basic rules? All right then let us take to it advanced level. There are types of incomes. Obviously just now I was not teaching you residential status, that is the next concept. Alright, that may be, we may do tomorrow. Today we are focusing on scope of total income. In scope of total income, you don't have to write anything. That chart I will show you. But please understand it's like this. Okay? There are two types of income. In scope of total income, there are two types of income. Indian income, and the next type of income?
Foreign
income. Very good. Okay? Foreign income. Indian income and foreign income. Okay? Now, so far as Indian income is concerned, very basic thing that if I have to tell you, that they are saying Indian income means income accrues in India. Income accrue or arise. There are two words. Later on I will not be using arise word. They are almost same. Income accrue or arise in India. Okay. The basic rule. Okay. Please understand here. Income accrues in India means what? Okay. To explain this, I would like to become a tree. Okay. Can you use your imagination and think that I am a tree?
Yes.
Mango tree. Okay. Whatever tree you like, but I like mango tree. So assume me as a mango tree. Okay. So income accrues in India means, please understand, this is our India-Pakistan border or India-Nepal border or India-Bhutan border or India-Bangladesh border, any foreign border, alright? This is India and this is some other nation, okay? If I stand here, that means I'm outside India, and if I stand here, I'm in
India.
Are we clear about this much? Okay, I'm a tree and these are my branches and there are mangoes on these branches. You tell me. If I have to ask you, tag this mango as Indian mango or foreign mango, what will you call?
Indian.
Why did you call it Indian mango?
Indian.
Because mango is in India or tree is in India?
Tree is in India.
That is more important. Please understand, everything has cause and effect analysis. Okay? There is a mango because there is a tree. Alright? Without a tree, you cannot see the mango. Yes or no?
Yes.
Your life also goes in a similar way. Okay? You are expecting some result. Without working on its cause, work on cause, result will be automatic. Yes, yes or no? Three idiots, kamyabi ke piche mat bhago. Kabil bano. The cause is kabil banna. You have to become able. Okay, now you people are disabled. Please understand, you are not able at all. Okay, you are using your talent, your skills in some other areas. Bring that on productive area, okay? And once you are working on your cause, you don't have to worry about fruit. Fruit will come automatically. Fruit is a byproduct, okay? Cause is more important. Are we clear about this one?
Yes.
So here also what I have to do, if I need a mango, I can't think about mango unless and until I plant a tree, all right? So I planted a tree in India. I provided the enough water to it. I had nurtured that particular tree by providing fertilizer, nutrition, whatever that tree needs. Okay, stable land, everything. Okay, now that tree has grown. This can be a business. This can be a house property income. It can be anything. But now that tree has the power to generate income in terms of fruit. Okay, in UK one case law happens, and in that case law, a judgment given judge was trying to establish these two relationship, cause and effect. So far as income and source is the relation. So if you want to have income, you should not think about income, you should think about source. You people don't have income because right now you people don't have source. If you have source, then there will be income. Hello? Alright? And income can be positive income and negative income. Negative income we call it as loss, but at least something should generate. Right now you are not generating anything because you don't have any source. Alright, so what that UK judgment said, that if you want to have income, there has to be some source, and if that source is located in India, the language was very important. If a source is located in India, or let us not write all those things, allow me to just write source rule instead of writing whole theory. We will write what is source rule in note. Okay, if you are having source in India, then that income is Indian income. Are we clear about it? Let me repeat. If you are having source in India, then that income is Indian income. Now what is source? Okay, and what is income? To explain this, he has taken amazing lines. Okay, if land is a source, then crop is an income. If a tree is a source, then fruit is an income. If a land is the source, then crop is the income. If a tree is the source, then fruit is the income. Alright. In a similar way, if a employment is the source, then salary is the income. If a house property is the source, then rent is the income. If a business is the source, then profit is the income. If capital asset is the source, then capital gain is the income. If a debenture is the source, then interest is the income. If equity source is the source, then dividend is the income. If preference shares is the source, then preference dividend is the income. So every income will have some sources, and if those sources are located in India, then the income will be called as Indian income. Okay, then whether you are a resident or non-resident will not make any difference. Even if you are a resident, you have to pay tax. Even if you are a non-resident, you have to pay tax, because income belongs to India. Because source belongs to India. We are also not talking about income. We are also focusing on source. Source in India, then the income out of this source is Indian income. And we as the government of India, we have control on this income. We have right to tax this income. Hello?
Yes.
All right. So again, I'm coming back to my mango tree. So these mangoes which are grown here, okay, taxable or not taxable?
Taxable.
But my owner is a resident, then? Taxable. My owner is non-resident, then?
Taxable.
Why? Because this tree itself is in India and we have right over that tree, okay? Now this is also my branch, okay? Branch. And this branch is outside India, you can see that, okay? Tree is in India, but one branch is outside India. So mango which are hanging here, they are actually outside India. So Indian mango or foreign mango?
Indian mango.
Indian mango. Why? Because you are not looking at mango. You are looking at source. You understood the law. You understood the source. If source is in India, then no matter where you are trying to show me your income, we will not look at income. We will look at the source. If source locates here, then Indian income. If source locates outside India, then it's not Indian income according to source. Am I clear?
Yes.
Alright. Then this is the rule one that I will be teaching you. Then we are having second rule, which is the receipt rule. Okay. In receipt rule, they say income received in India. Second rule of taxation is income
received in India.
Received in India. So first income was income accrued in India. Second income is income
received
in India. To explain, allow me to go here. Okay. This was income accrued in India. Yes or no? That mango falls on Indian land. Accrued in India, received in India. When it was in air on that branch, was it Indian mango?
Yes.
Now it came down. Still it is?
Indian mango.
Indian mango. So if we have already defined this mango as Indian mango, then please do not apply receipt rule to it. Because you have already applied and discussed and finalized, okay, this is Indian mango. Yes or no? This mango. You only told me this is Indian mango according to source rule. Now this mango falls on the land of Pakistan. Now it is, the fallen mango is Indian mango or foreign mango? That is on not my land now. Now that mango is on foreign land. But that mango is still Indian mango or foreign mango? Indian mango. Why? Because that mango has source in
India.
Again, I'm telling you, do not look at that place of receipt. Look at the place of accrual. Place of accrual was in India.
Yes.
Then it is Indian mango. Okay. The once it is defined as per source rule that this is Indian income, do not apply any other rule, because you already defined it that this is Indian income. Do not apply receipt rule where you have already applied source rule. Okay. And once it is Indian income, it will remain Indian income. This is also Indian income. This is also Indian income. Okay. Now allow me to go here. This is now, I mean outside India territory. Yes or no?
Yes.
Any foreign country. Need not to also attach to India. Okay, any foreign country. Alright. Now this is the mango tree here.
Yes.
Indian mango or foreign mangoes?
Foreign mangoes.
Okay. Hello? Foreign mango fallen on foreign land. Do we have right in that mango?
No.
No, because that is on foreign land. Okay. But foreign mango fall on Indian land. Indian mango or foreign mango? Indian mango, because they know, I guess. Indian mango because it was accrued outside India but directly received in India. Accrued outside India but directly received in India. And therefore, government has created second rule. Okay? As per rule 1, it is foreign mango. That is right. But according to received rule, it is Indian mango. So then we did not apply this rule in first situation. Yes, because that time it was Indian income. See, I as a government here, I am not here to define what is foreign income. Okay? Because if I define it as a foreign income, it will not be taxable. Responsibility of government of India to define what is Indian income. What is foreign, what is income in Pakistan or not, that is Pakistan government will look after. I should not look after that. As the government of India, I am concerned about whether it is taxable in India or not. Okay? So mangoes in India, they are taxable in India. Mango accrued outside India but fallen on Indian land. We want to tax that mango also. That is our attitude. We want to tax it. We are taxing it. But since the source rule is not applicable, we have second rule. Received rule. But that country is not following that. That is problem of that country. Yeah. My country want to follow two rules. Hello. Yes. If you understand source rule, then there is a see, once you reach at particular level, then we should reach to another level. Yes or no? Yes. Till yesterday you were not knowing anything about it. Yeah. Alright. Today morning you came in 15 minutes, you learn about source rule. So we reach up to this level. Now my responsibility to take it to another level. Yes or no?
Yes.
If you were same yesterday, today also you are same, and tomorrow also you are same, that means you know we have successfully wasted your whole day.
Yes.
Yesterday you were different, today you are different, and tomorrow also you are different. Your thoughts have changed, your personality has changed gradually. See, suddenly accident will not happen and you will not transform into great personality. Greatness happens very slowly. Alright? And therefore, we need to keep adding knowledge, concepts, philosophies, thoughts every day. That's what I am doing. So, are we clear about source rule? Then only I will go to a receipt rule because that is the second rule. Alright? So, mango which are accrued in India are taxable because of source rule, source in India. Whether it is received in India or outside India, will not change my nature of mango. It will remain Indian mango. Now, mango accrued in foreign nation, received in foreign nation are not falling in this category.
Yes.
But mango accrued outside India, but fallen directly on India, they are in this category. Second category, receipt rule. This is the second rule of taxation. Receipt rule. Okay? Hello?
Yes.
Alright. Now, this was okay. Seriously, this was okay. That means, can you define foreign income for me? If you understand this much, income accrued outside India as well as received outside India, because there are four combinations by using this two concept. Okay, income accrued in India, received in India. Define which income? Indian income, foreign income? Accrued in India, received in India, Indian income. Accrued in India, received outside India. Why? Because accrued in India. Okay, income accrued outside India and received in India.
Indian
income, not as per source rule, but as per
receipt
rule. Am I clear? So that means income accrued outside India and received outside India is foreign income.
Yes.
Alright?
Yes.
Itna to clear hai? Pakka? Sure. Out of four combinations, three combinations are Indian income and one
foreign.
That means what is foreign income, sir? Foreign income means accrued outside India, received outside India. And technically government of India should take tax on Indian income, not on
foreign income.
Yes or no? I will take you to another level next time. But as this up to this level, Indian government should take tax on Indian income, not on
foreign
income. Are we clear about this much? Okay. If you know this, that Indian government is taking approximately 30-40% tax. Okay. Would you like to plant your tree in India? 30-40% tax. Hello. If there are 100 mangoes on this tree, government is going to take 40 mangoes out of it. And if I tell you there is a country in Mauritius, country like Mauritius or some other country, Dubai or any other random country, where tax rate is 2%. Out of 100, they will take only 2. And then there are tax havens where tax rate is 0% or 0.02%. You are getting my point? Out of 1000 mangoes, they will take 2 mangoes. Okay, where would you like to plant your tree?
Outside.
You understand? Achha, outside, but which country that you will think, and then you should not outside means you should not go to Iran, Iraq. Okay? Nahi sir, wahan pe tax ka problem nahi hai. But you are working on laptop, missile comes and you die. Okay? So you need to check political situation in that country. You need to check security laws in that country or a stability in that country. The land has to be fertile, yes or no?
Yes.
Alright, you are thinking about business in Mauritius, but Mauritius has population less than Mumbai. How will you grow there? What type of business you can? See, without population, you cannot run a business. Jio was successful in India because we have population. India's strength is population and people are working day and night hard to make it larger and larger day by day. You are the product of that. Everyone knows this. Okay, you are not fallen from sky. Right? Some people are working day and night. Huh? Thanks to them. That at least we have one resource, human resource. Alright, we will create other resources, but as of now, at least we are strong in one resource, human resource. Alright, so other companies knows that if I start business in Mauritius, it will grow, but only to this level. If I start business in some other country, it will grow, but up to this level. If I start business in Maldives, it will grow, but it up to this level. But if I start business in India, it will grow tremendously. People know this, alright, and therefore these many foreign companies are there in India. But problem with India is that they are having high amount of taxes. So what type of people planning, tax planning, earlier people have done this, okay, is that they have created legal entity outside India. Legally, that entity will be outside India. That entity will do business also outside India, okay. But everything they will control from here. Alright? So, business is outside India, but actually it is in India. It's like that. Legally it is outside India, but really it is in India. Okay?
Yeah.
Drishya. They are trying to show you something else, whereas reality is something else.
Yes.
Okay? And people believe in that something else because that is legal. Court doesn't see reality. Court see legality. That legally it is valid, then only it is valid. Legally it is invalid, then it is invalid. Logics and all court doesn't have. Court can't see anything, therefore there is a black ribbon on the eye of court. Court cannot see. Okay? They will only listen to the law and the fact. If facts are according to law, then your facts are valid. If your facts are voiding law, then your facts are invalid. It's that simple. They don't look into emotions and all. Okay? They don't have emotions. And that is fair. Hello? Alright? Therefore, what some people have done earlier, they have evaded taxes. Yes or no? This is the reality. People have evaded taxes by manipulating in laws. Alright? To control that, government has created certain provisions. Okay? Those provisions are called deeming fictions in law. Those provisions are known as deemed. Deemed. Ye word padha hoga na? Deemed. Deemed matlab assumed. Assume is not a right word for deemed. Deemed is itself word. Okay? Assume matlab something is not. So assume there is a God. That is assumption. Okay? It is not assumption. It's not imagination. Deemed. Maan lo. Alright. Tum nalayak ho. Maan lo. I'm not saying it. But what's wrong in deeming it, isn't it? Alright? So you deemed it that you are not good enough or you are not capable enough and then work upon it. Alright, so next point is this, please understand, income deemed to be received in India. Kya point padha raha hu? Income deemed to be received in India, and this is written in section 7. This is written in section 7. That I have already told you, this is written in section 7. Income deemed to be received in India, and then we are having lastly income deemed to be accrued in India. This is in section 9. Okay. Section 9, okay? If you ask me to choose one difficult section out of 750 section that income tax have, I'll choose section 9, alright? Because this is something you need to understand at very higher maturity level, and that too at CMA final, or CA final, not at intermediate level. We don't teach these things at intermediate level. It's that high. Okay? But if we don't start now, you will not even understand at CA final, CMA final level. Therefore, we just initiate it. We just start it. We just give it to start. Okay? Then automatically by reading and working and having idea about it, people say, no, read newspaper. They are not talking about local newspaper. They are talking about business newspaper where you will see impact of section 9 and all. Alright? So gradually you will reach at a level where you will understand things in a more better way, more clearer way. If you understand basic law. So right now I am not teaching you whole section 9. I can't, because there is no whole section 9 in your syllabus. But at least 30-40% of section 9 is there, and that much I will teach you. Okay? So it's something like this. Okay, how deeming fiction works in law. I told you people have done evasion and then government is doing anti-evasion. Okay, this is anti-evasion thing. People have evaded it and then we are trying to control it. Can you hold like this, like something like you, can you hold your hand? Assume that I am giving you 10 lakh rupees, okay? I gave her 10 lakh rupees, you assumed it? They said deem 10 lakh, go and pay tax on this 10 lakh, go. Are you don't, it will fall. There are 10 lakhs in your hand, you assume that there are 10 lakhs in your hand and you have to pay tax on 10 lakh, go. 30% is the rate. Will she pay it?
No.
No, government is doing this. There is no tree in India, there is no income accrued in India, not received in India, man loaners. They are asking us, maan lo na, it is there in India, or edo tax de do. Nahi hai tree, maan lo na ki hai. Sir, nahi received nahi, maan lo na ki mila hai. Sir, government itna gira hua kaise ho sakta hai? Bata raha hu kyu gira hua government itna. Hai yahan pe to I will pay tax. I'll happily pay tax on this because there is a tree in India. I'll pay tax on it.
Yes.
Nahi hai, nothing is there. Maan lo na. It's like that, okay? So sir, then where is the tree? The tree is in Pakistan or Nepal or Bhutan or some other nation, okay? So this is the tree. Mangoes are accrued outside India. Mangoes are received outside India. Mangoes are also consumed outside India. Nothing is coming to India, alright? Then our Indian government was on some roundup. Some of income tax officers were just on roundup, they go here and there, alright? And they had feeling, okay, let's have some mangoes in Pakistan or some mangoes in Nepal, some other country, because they have visited there. So they took mango fortunately from this tree only, alright? They tested it. It tested the same way like Indian mangoes taste. They are same, akin, alright? They were exactly same. Size, shape, color, taste. Then they were very much surprised, oh, Pakistan mango should taste different. Nepal mango should taste different. At least some difference should be there.
Yes.
Alright. They said, but it is exactly same. Then it caused some kind of suspicious activity. Alright. And they took legal permission from government of that foreign country, whatever is the country. Can we start digging here? Alright. Now because it is Indian government, Modi uncle, nobody can control him. So, okay, you start digging, no problem. Then he started digging from that tree. Okay, they found the root, main root, and that root they found, they started digging it, and they reached to India. Alright, on face, tree is in Pakistan or any foreign nation, alright, but in reality, the roots of trees are in
India.
So, all nutrition, values, hello, water, whatever you say, okay, they are deriving from
India.
They are actually deriving from India. So, this plant jisne lagaya hai na, usually you when you have to plant a seed, you have to plant like this straight, so that tree will come like this. Someone has planted this seed like this. Okay, thoda teda. Alright. And the tree has grown like this. Alright. So, that tree has started in India, but it has ended up in Pakistan. With a naked eye, if you see, the tree is in Pakistan. That is not in India. Everything is happening in Pakistan because this is drishyam that we wanted to show. That company wanted to show. Whole business they have set up outside India. Everything is outside India. Hello? Legally, reality, their capital, their technology, way of doing business, management, they are from
India.
So government says enough. Okay, that tree is also Indian tree. You say, no sir, that tree is in Pakistan. Maan lo. Kaha hai? Assume, deemed. एंड मान लो मीन्स आई एम नॉट रिक्वेस्टिंग प्लीज मान लो ये है दिस इज हाउ इट इज अज्यूम इज इट लाइक रिक्वेस्टिंग प्लीज अज्यूम इट नो नो वी हैव डी